Please stand in for one hour.
Short feedback in order for us to improve and learn from you.
So, we have a performance, or you are the performance?
So, this is one of the questions. You can all turn left now and take the back of your first.
Put your hands above the person who is in front of you. We are going to be divided in two groups. One is pro-revolution and the other one is against revolution. So the people who are pro-revolution should go over there and the people that are against revolution over there.
Why are you against revolution?
Difficult to say actually, but mostly personal, like my personal background.
You've been seeing, you have seen the revolution and the results of it, or why?
I have seen one, yes.
Which one?
Actually, I have seen the result of the 1979 revolution in Iran. So, yeah.
You've been living there?
I was born there, yes.
What happened?
1979. I mean, until 1978, there was a king, the Shah of Persia. And before him, it was his father, and it was actually some kind of military state, but with a king. And then after the revolution, 1978, and actually 1979, it was like formed into an Islamic state, into the state we know now as the Islamic State of Iran. So. Actually, the political situation back then was instrumentalized for establishing this sort of religious-led state, which I think can never work nowhere. So I think revolutions are some kind of, and this is more generally speaking, some kind of instrument for the wrong people to gain what they want, to form the state. But
you didn't mention the war.
Yes, actually, there was no. I mean, it was a civil, something like a civil war, as far as I know. But, or you mean the Iraq war?
Yeah.
Yes, this was one of the consequences. But, yeah. I mean, still, even if the war wouldn't have happened, which is hard to say, but still, I think that the state in itself failed, like the way it is conceptualized. So, yeah.
Are you able to return to Iran?
Yes, I am. But my parents weren't for a few years, and nowadays, even the ones who were politically very active can go back now and travel back and forth. But it's like, it's some sort of people there who are like the government. They saw at some point that they have to be like having their concept a bit loose or loosen it up just to make sure that there won't be another revolution. So, yeah.
And if you're against the revolution, what kind of way do you consider for change?
I think the revolution or the revolution is just the word itself is wrong. I think the word itself is like this sort of big thing. I think there can be many small revolutions happening, but a revolution or the revolution is like, I don't know what that even is. So, and the way it was, or the ways of revolutions that I've experienced in Iran were like, to me, critical, but.
Would you think of another revolution in Iran, throwing away that?
Yes, I mean, depending on what would happen afterwards, which we never can say before. I spoke to a friend of mine like a few weeks ago, and he was like, there can't be another change or a big change without being armed and without a big war. Like civil war, so and since I'm not living in the country, I can't tell for people what to do and what not to do. So I don't know.
Not yet, but I live in Russia, and we're still in the process of fighting, but it's just little amount of people who are against the regime we have right now. And there was a period during the second election of Putin where, when we all were in the streets during several days, stay there and protesting. But in this period, we thought that the revolution could be possible in Russia. But afterwards, it failed, and Putin came back, and all the efforts and the energy of protests just flew away, and just we thought that what we've been doing is just a performance. So he reacted in one way, and it was awful because several people are still in prison after that. But right now we experience a new energy trying to push the regime from down. And I think that in Russia, there is no way to change something, just revolution. but I do not know in what kind of form it could happen. So that's why for me it's a kind of also personal question.
Mm-hmm. And what do you think about the election system in Russia?
There is no. I mean, it's obvious. We have this check, changing Putin Medvedev or somebody who is pro-Putin, and this is just a person, but the background is every time the same.
Mm-hmm.
And there is no election, and we're waiting for the next year when it will happen, and I do not know what will happen. I'm not sure that people have such an energy like 4 years, 6 years ago, because they're afraid, because a lot of people are in prison because of the political reasons, protests and all this stuff. And I don't know, there is no election. We are not voting for this president. But I know that 50% of Russian people who are aged, who do not really react to the changes they were, but still it's not clear.
In favor of violence, but I'm in favor of revolution if it means change. But I think some situations cannot be born as they are, and you have to be in favor of change for the better.
Yes, but actually this is exactly the crucial point for me, that I mean, that's the ideal of a revolution, like change for the better, but what is the better? For me, maybe the better might have been, so might be something different.
Of course.
Like somebody else.
But is there a middle thinkable?
Politically, you mean?
Or no, in general, I would like to not be against revolution.
Yes, exactly. Yeah, this is exactly what, yeah.
Ignore it as a kind of means to an end.
Could some of us make like a summary, a brief summary? Someone that haven't spoken yet. Yeah?
Would you like to tell me what happened?
Yeah, we experienced something, revolution.
Actually, I have no idea.
这是一个用身体去解释战争的一个行为，就是通过声音去表达自己的身体。
Okay, now that you have a clue, we can continue with the revolution and maybe try to form it a little bit, like to try to find something more concrete about revolution. Maybe we can connect it with the score. I think you have read the score of the concert, and where could we place the revolution in it? How could we perform it in a revolutionary way? Why are you standing here?
Sitting. I'm sitting.
Why are you sitting?
I wanted to change the balance between one individual and a group.
Do you think this is helpful for the score?
I don't know. It said practical, so.
Do you know why she's standing there?
No. Do you?
Yes.
Can you tell me?
You can ask her.
Do you know why you're?
I was asked if I wanted to be something like an observer, since I was the one who took the different position, and because I said that somehow I've experienced the revolution, in contrast to probably the rest of the group, which I'm not sure yet. But so that's why I was asked to sit here.
Does the fact that I'm sitting here now change your position on the material?
No, not at all.
Does anyone think that it changes anything?
But as you said, you changed the balance. But it's uncomfortable.
I don't know if it really did. That's why. What do you think? Did it change the balance? Or her position is not sure.
Did you want to do something revolutionary? Was this your target?
What would the revolution be for you in 2017?
I guess, an accumulation of small changes by individuals. But I must admit that I have no... For me, revolution, as the revolution you described, and also the Russian revolution you described, it's a really big abstract thing. So if I try to understand it, I make it smaller and I translate into small changes or accomplishments for individuals. So maybe yes, in that sense, this was a revolutionary act and intended to be. I don't know, what do you think?
Do you have any suggestion? If you think that there is a revolution, what we should do?
I like the idea to make a small change.
Like what?
The just the little people and you can start with yourself, with your thinking and change that. How we react together, and it's a smaller practice. It's not made by the state or by politics, it's made by the people.
By the self?
Yeah.
What is the self?
It's a relation to the others.
What does it mean?
You're always... in a correlation to other people, to the environment. Can't be yourself, you're always with the others.
How long have you been here now?
We think we are self. And now we are in a crew, but we are always in a group, and we should start to think that we are not ourselves, that we relate to others.
You have agreement?
Could we try it out now, simultaneously, like a short improvisation all together? Stand up and do whatever comes to our mind first, like small changes or small gestures, revolutionary gestures.
Like walking together with
why they were in strike?
Why is there a strike? Are you afraid your papers? I believe that the time is.
Sorry, I can't hear you. Can you repeat, please, yourself?
Sorry? I don't know why people are on strike today.
I didn't hear you, that's all.
Because you get some your retirement.
Mm-hmm.
There are more taxes, people here, that's what I understand.
That's what you read in the papers.
Sorry?
That's what you read in the papers.
Yeah.
I believe that there are many kinds of revolution. Not only the strike, not only the protest. This is a difficult subject to discuss with somebody because
everybody has different opinion about revolution. Some people believe that revolution is a word, but some other people believe that it isn't a word. It is something more pacific, and when you protest, you want to take your right back. And when you deal with the arts or
was violent. Why?
That I wouldn't help. What do you mean by that person? I wasn't even born back then, so I couldn't help.
No, he said it was another one then.
Yes. Ah.
Wouldn't you help?
What is helping? What
I
is help?
Know.
You wouldn't know better than I.
This is exactly the point. I don't think that I know better than the people living there. So.
Yeah, but if they started something, something started there.
If I would go there to fight with them.
Yeah, or at least maybe send some money or some help. Or
I don't think that sending money in a state which has a revolution is even possible from them. How could I send money?
Or try to give a home to the people who have to escape for a while.
I'm doing that. I mean, I would do that even now. This is not an option. Are we desperate?
Yeah, well, maybe you're right. Maybe there's no hope.
I don't think that there is no hope, but still, I don't feel desperate. No.
What could bring hope for you?
I don't know if people over there decided to, they couldn't bear it anymore. If we men decided not to obey the law, it might happen.
I think today we posed that question that typically very often comes up, and the question, in my opinion, is what do we put in the place of the master? How, if we want change, what we have to put in the place of the current power? And it seems that neither today people had any good argument about what we have to do. People seem that they want change, but in the same time, so the problems that when it comes to the actual action, what it happens, and this is very problematic in my opinion, as it has been proven also in the past in other cases, in my opinion. And this is on research, I think.
talking about the Iran. We suddenly, all women refused to put a headscarf because they killed a woman.
Sorry, what did you say?
I said talking about Iran. Mm-hmm. If all women decided one day not to wear a headscarf, mm-hmm. could
yes,
they kill them all?
This is exactly the point. You're thinking that this would be the ideal thing to happen, but it is not that every woman over there doesn't want to wear a headscarf.
Okay.
So, at first point, this
okay.
is...
But when all people unite for an idea, I think.
Yes, but this is just an ideal thing. This is never possible. Why do you think that everybody, like every individual on the planet or in the country, can have the same?
I don't think it's going to happen. Just an example show that. Right?
There was something like that in 2009, actually, after the elections, that people weren't. They thought that there was something wrong with the result of the elections, and they started protesting and they were.
It's just a small thing.
It wasn't just a small thing. There were like people selling themselves, just shooting to the ballot.
I think today it was very real. To me, it felt very real. I felt that the two groups, the one pro-revolution and the other against, was very, very representative of a very real situation. I felt very, very honored by having a person that actually experienced the revolution inside the space. And the situation created, I think, was very powerful. I was expecting a bit for people to react with a slap. It was just an attempt to create real violence in a very small length and small scale. Inside a room where everybody talks about revolution, but as if violence is not real.
But it wasn't real, at least to me it didn't feel real.
Yeah, I mean, I'm with you at some point. It didn't feel real, but the act itself was real. So it happened, but it felt like motivation felt artificial, so
I think we started in a very concentrating way. And this created attention from everybody. I think we should have done something with the people that came later, because we only asked them something in the beginning, and then I felt they were not, their entrance was not well exploited by us. But, yeah, and as for, I think the conversation was very interesting, and once again, it's obvious that we mean many different things, but when we use a term so open and so broad as revolution, it felt very, very difficult to... I mean, we didn't have the same idea and we didn't have the same image in our head when we said this word and when we used this term. And the woman explaining what we are talking about in Chinese was to me very, very to the point of what was happening at this point. Yeah, and I guess as we talk about revolution and we don't mean the same thing, but we have to start meaning the same thing in order to come together to form something as a revolution or I don't know what. I guess we have to start to share things in order to find a common use of the terms.
Coming.
going back again to what you said, that revolution is a very broad notion and that you don't want to restrain it in a way by understanding it. But how is it possible for someone to act if they don't know what they're acting for?
Considering it's not possible. Is they act because they know what for. They don't know what's going to happen finally, but usually people who take the risk to act, they know what for. I said that the results can be quite different from what they expect.
Considering the, regarding the slab, I would say that considering my physical background as a dancer, I would say that sometimes the intention of the actual of the somatic action itself is strong enough to create a further intention. So I would disagree with you. And if you really fight with someone, you can feel that. And I would add a last comment about the space that we have formed so far. I think it's very interesting because it's like we are the four of us. You were the only person that sat on the chair, and I would say that it's not totally random because from the beginning you saw that you have the confidence to separate yourself from the group, and you were at the beginning you were the only person against revolution, and then we have you know each other, no?
Yeah.
You know each other, no? Okay. And you came later and you're still standing, just the two of you. So I think the formation of the space is very interesting as a just an observation. And
I feel to say something. Yes, we've been the ones who came late. It's more like being an audience. I don't know what your arrangement and agreements are here. I have no idea what you were doing. But I come back to your slapping. You said can create like real impression of fighting. That was a stage slap. It did not create anything more than a stage response, kind of like I'm staging emotions. It did not get anywhere that lead to violence. No one attacked the slapper, or nobody felt like, right? And I think that's the same situation with revolutions. You cannot plan a revolution. You cannot talk about a revolution. A revolution is